Hi everyone. Today we are going to talk about subscription management under Client Portal. This is a brand new feature and this update makes your life so much easier, especially if you want your customers to handle their own subscription to your courses or in your paid community. So let's dive into it and see how this is going to help you.
So to access the community, we click on memberships here and then communities and groups. This will take you to the community that you have built out. If you don't have a community, all you have to do is click here to create a group and give it a name, URL, description, and add the logo and all that. And once you click create group, you will have a new group created for you. So that's how easy it is to create a group in Go High Level. So this is a community that I have built out some time ago. And if I want to log in into this community as an admin, all I have to do is click here to log in. And now I am already inside my community. If I click here on top left on my home screen, it will take me to my accounts page. And on the right hand side, I can see a bunch of options. One is join group, take course, affiliate earning, and the last one is billing and subscription. This is the new update. If I click here, it will take me to my billing and subscription page where I can see all the subscriptions and invoices that I have. If you're accessing it for the first time, it will ask for a confirmation code. Once you enter that confirmation code, it will take you to your subscription, invoices, and transaction tabs. Now you can see I have a subscription here, which is coming from membership, which is actually for a course that I paid for. And then the amount and the status is active. If you want to see the transaction details, all I have to do is click here and click on view. And then you can see the next invoice is on October 2nd, a month from now. And then you have subscription ID, download ID, and all that. And if you want to cancel that subscription, all you have to do is click here and click on cancel. And this way, your user or your contact can cancel their subscription from their own end. So that's how you can cancel your subscription. Now, in case you want to update your card details, all you have to do is click on here, share update payment link. And then you will get a link here. So if you access that link, this is where you can update your card details. If you add a new card details here, it will get updated in the system. Now you can see how easy it is for a community member to cancel their subscription or to update their card without needing to contact you for all such things, right? So as an admin, it also makes your life so much easier because you don't have to handle all the questions and back and forth. Now the community member have the option to update or cancel their subscription. It also gives you a place to find all the invoices that a person has under your account. And another great feature is that you can actually filter through your transactions or invoices and subscriptions. When you click on filters, you can see the status. You can select all the transaction as per the status. If you just want to select the failed or pending transactions, you can select so and apply that filter. You can also find the source of all these transactions or subscription. Now, in case you are worried that people would cancel their subscriptions now that they have this choice and you don't want to show this billing and subscription, you can do so by going back to your client portal, click on sites, and go to client portal and go under settings in client portal. And this is where you can find app permissions. When you click on app permissions, you can see billing and subscription is a new tab that is added. All you have to do is uncheck this box. Once you uncheck it, when people sign in, when people log in to their community, they cannot see this. So if that's what you want, you can just simply uncheck this and it will not show in the front end. So that's how you can toggle this on and off. And now another question you might have is that how can you make your community a paid community? To do that, all you have to do is go to your communities page and make sure that you are logged in as an admin. And then you click on the settings here. This is where you can add a subscription to your community and make it a paid community. You can also make this a public or private community by going into the settings and details. So for example, if it is subscription based, if I select price and click save, And now if I access this page in an incognito window, instead of join now, it will ask you to subscribe with that monthly fee. So when you click here, it'll ask you to sign up. If you're already logged in, if you already have an account, you can just simply log in. But if you don't have an account, you just create an account first. I'm just going to create an account. Once I enter the code, it'll ask me to make the payment. So this is a test mode, so I can just enter test card number. So I entered the test card number. Now I click confirm payment. Payment successful. Just need to add an image here to get started with the community. So just add an image, click complete. Now this is a private community and my membership is still pending. So as an admin, I have to go and approve this membership. If I go back to my account and refresh this account, I should see a notification on top right. You can see the notification and then I can simply accept this request. Request approve. And if you go back and refresh this page, instead of membership pending, you will be part of this community. Now you are logged in into this community. And if you go into your account, go to billing, it'll ask you for a confirmation code. And once you enter the confirmation code, you can see the subscription that you are on. And if you go to view the subscription, you will see the next invoice is on October 3rd, 1 month from now. In case you want to cancel this, you can click here and cancel the subscription. So this is for the subscription for the community. Now you can also manage the subscription for a course that you have. So in order to access that, you go to courses. And if you have a subscription fee for the course, that will also come under this subscription management. So in here, I already have a course because it's a free course that everyone gets access to. But if I go into my offer and create a recurring offer, let me quickly show that. So if you go to your account and go to memberships, and if you go to your products, this is all the courses that you have. Now, in order to sell that course, you create an offer. So you go into offers, and I have an offer here, test recurring offer. If you go in here, you can see this offer pricing is 1 AUD per month. And there is 0 trial period, and there are 3 number of payments. So this is a recurring subscription to access the course content, okay? And you can select the product that you have. You can also add multiple products into this offer. So it's asking if I should give to an existing member or not. Just click whatever works for you. Now I have added 2 products under this offer and then I can click save. Now, if I go here and select this link and if I go to my incognito window, access this, okay, I have added my details, so you can check out. Again, this is in test mode, so I quickly added the test card details and confirm payment. And it asks me to log in. Now that I have already logged in, it's taking me straight into my account. Now if I click link subscription here, you can see there are 2 subscriptions now. One is for the community itself, and the second one is for the membership, which is the course that I just enrolled. And if I don't want to continue with the course, all I have to do is click here and cancel this. And when I cancel this, I will still be part of the community, but the course will no longer be accessible. Similarly, if you cancel community membership, you will no longer be part of the community. You will still have access to the course. So this is how your group members can take charge of their subscription management all by themselves without contacting you. As a user, you have complete control over your subscription. As an admin, you don't have to worry about subscription management. Now, as an admin, what you can do is if you go to your contacts and select that payment tab here, you can see all the transactions and subscriptions and invoices all under one place. So in case someone is still contacting you to cancel their subscription, all you have to do is go to their contact and find this tab called payments, and then click on subscriptions, and it will take you to the subscriptions that are relevant to that contact only. And then you can see their subscriptions here, and then you can either cancel their subscription or you can send this link to them so that they can update their payment details. So this is how easy it is to manage your subscriptions with this new update. So I hope this is helpful. If you have any questions, please let me know. I'll see you in the next one. Thank you. Bye.